Hey guys, this is my first video that I'm doing on my Honda Grom, kind of what I've been doing to it since I got it on October 2014. As you can see, as we do a walk around here, first thing I did was I eliminated the that whale tail, I guess that people call it, and then I put in a Vagabond tidy tail type thing, and they're from San Diego. I ordered it from eBay, good price. The second mod I did was the Hard Racing Chimera intake that I got from hardracing.com. Really good company to work with. They're very prompt in their responses. And today, what I'm doing today is I just wanted to show how flimsy this is with the with this bar right here. Is what it comes with. It's pretty adequate, but the thing is, you can see, I don't know if you can see it from here, but if you look closely, the screws don't set in too well. And I guess that was my fault because I should have screwed these in right, but they're coming at an angle. So this is a little bit looser than it should be, I think. So what I did was I ordered some fairing brackets from RPM. And I'll be installing this and hopefully it'll work with the setup that I have here. Once again, it's a Chimera. What I'm also gonna do is use my Tascam DR-40 to actually record what the sound is like. And I'll provide a link on the bottom of the comment section, probably a SoundCloud or a Soundbite. And as I go through my mods, you'll be able to like get a good feel for what it sounds like. I personally like the Chimera intake. I feel a difference, especially in the torquiness of the bike. But I also have a feeling that it's running a little lean. Last time I checked the plug, it was kind of white, and that's with the stock exhaust. Right now I have the K Factory S exhaust, I guess, S line exhaust. That's from Wii Bike in Japan. It took about a month, and that's gonna be my next video. But for today, I'm going to be doing the taking the panels off and putting in the RPM brackets. And maybe you might not need to use this anymore, but we'll see. So hope you like it. Okay, so there's like tons of resources out on the internet right now. It shows you how to take off the fairings properly. So I'll just leave it up to that. That's why I'm just showing you what it looks like right here. Also, thing I want to point out is this thing has like plastic tabs, like that yellow tab right there. You really don't want to break that off. So just please be careful when you try to operate on yours. So here's kind of what it looks like without the fairing braces and with RPM fairing braces, which I'll be putting on next. Okay, so here are the RPM brackets. If you haven't seen them on their website yet, but it's a really thin aluminum, machined aluminum. It looks pretty good quality wise. It's a little, I feel like you can bend these actually. At the time that I bought them, they were about $43. I've seen that recently they've lowered the price on these, so if you can get your hands on these are pretty good. Basically, the rubber grommets from the airbox will go in here, and then these are going to go up here. As you can see already, there's going to be some conflict with the bracket and the air filter, the Chimera system. So I'm going to see what I can do to make this thing fit. So here it is with the RPM fairing brace on. As you can see, it doesn't really clear the air filter, but it's, you know, the air filter itself has rubber around it. So, but when I put it together, it was pretty firm. A lot better than just having just the bar across that the Chimera came with. So basically right now I'm gonna be doing both sides and then checking to see whether or not there's play in between. And if we have to, we'll add that Chimera bar as well from hardracing.com. So here it is with the RPM brackets on. I do notice a noticeable difference in the flex. Really solid, doesn't move. When I had just the bar in there, straight across, it flexed quite a bit. And also when you're riding, sometimes it gets kind of turbulent, it'll do that. I was gonna put the bar back in, but because of the way that the filter is now positioned a little bit lower, that bar will not be able to fit across without hitting the filter. So right now, I'm gonna put it all together. I'm gonna use my Tascam to record the sound, so to get a better representation of what it sounds like, I have a dedicated sound recorder for that.